Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, you'll learn how to customize the Action Contextual Menus. The menus were introduced in the Flame 2018.2 update, and hopefully they have increased your usability and speed when working in the Action 3D Compositor. The menus give you quick access to most of the Action objects, as well as reveal functionality that was hidden in previous versions of the Flame products. This includes dynamically updating the available options when calling up the contextual menus over various selected Action objects. So what you see in the menus is the standard supplied tools that you would normally find in the node bin. But what if you wanted to customize the menus for various selections, as well as add your own custom tools to the contextual menu? Well, the good news is that these contextual menus are fully editable because they are in an XML text file which you can customize. So regardless of what operating system you are using, open up your favorite text editor. Using its browser, navigate to /opt/autodesk/presets/theflameversion/action/context menu. Here you will find a file called actioncontextmenu.xml. Open this file. Scrolling through the script, there are various sections which define the options for the different sections in Action. For example, scroll towards the bottom of the script to get to the surface section. So if you add an option in this section, whenever you call up the contextual menu over a selected surface, these options will appear, including any extras you have added. Now with all situations, before you make any changes to this file, let's save our own version. This means you can always go back to the original if required. Let's call this file flc_context.xml. Now you can also save it wherever you want. For example, I'll save mine into /var/temp. Now that you're working in your own version, let's make some changes. Just by looking at the syntax of the other lines, it is easy to figure out what to type. Now there is already an entry to take you to the Autodesk Matchbox shaders. But let's say you also have some of the free Logic Matchbox shaders. Now the typical practice is to call up the Matchbox shader node, and then you manually navigate to the external shaders. But let's say you wanted a contextual option that took you straight to your custom shader folder. So you'll add the following. After the original matchbox entry, you'll add another separator string again. This is not necessary, but it keeps the menu neat. Next, type the following line. This is a matchbox entry. This can be any recognizable name you want. And finally, you type the file path for the shaders. This is the folder where I've placed mine, but you can have any path you choose. Now save the file. When you switch back to Flame, if you select the surface object and call up the contextual menu, you will see that none of your changes have taken. This is because you need to point Flame to the new file. So open the Flame preferences using Ctrl+Alt+F6. Looking at the Timeline Effects Batch and Batch Effects preferences, at the bottom right of the menu, you will find the Action Context Menu Config File Path. This is a mouthful, but this is the pointer to the Action Contextual Menu file. click Browse, and navigate to your saved XML file. Mine is located in the /var/temp directory. When you select the file, it updates in the Preferences menu. That's all you need to do. Now close the Preferences and call up the contextual menu on the selected image surface. Here you will now see the Custom Shaders option. When you select it, it will take you to the file browser, and you'll be looking at the path you specified in the XML file. So that's a quick way of getting to your custom tools. But what if you wanted to use your favorite GLSL matchbox shader all the time without having to navigate any directories? For example, I love the Croc Pixelate shader, and I want to have it directly in my contextual menu when I select a surface. You can also script this in the XML file. So switch back to the editor, and we'll add another entry just under the one you've added. Once again, you can add a separator string just for tidy's sake. Now we know that the Pixelate shader exists in the directory with all the custom shaders. So in the interests of saving time, copy and paste the previous entry. Change the name tag to Pixelate This. Now when you point to a directory or folder like this, the file browser will launch in flame when you choose this option. However, if you place a direct link to this file, Flame will just apply it straight to the selection. So let's add the file to the end of this file path. Type /croc_pixelate.glsl. That's it. Now save the file again. This time, when you return back to Flame, the update should have already taken place without rebooting or restarting the application. Select the image object and call up the contextual menu. There is the option for the custom shader, and when you select Pixelate This, the Croc Pixelate shader will be added to the image object without the need to navigate any directories. So customizing your Action Contextual menus is not too difficult, and the files could be centralized on your network if you have multiple Flame products to access the same custom menus. Hopefully, this is an additional productivity boost to your workflow when using the Action 3D Compositor. Don't forget to also check out the other enhancements, workflows, and features to the Flame 2018.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.